what do you think the obligation is for people to know about the historical roots and origins of horror scary movies?
The roller skate resurgence. For some, this phrase might make you think back to the early days of the COVID-19 lockdowns where glittering wheels, funky throwback jams, and bright colored outfits flooded the feeds of TikTok and Instagram. But to those who cultivated this skate style long before and never stopped, this new wave of skating popularity triggers an uncomfortable question. Is culture being lost amidst a shuffle of novelty and trend? To learn more about skate culture, I sat down with Sunset Roller Club, a San Diego skate group formed in the midst of COVID-19, and Dee Upshaw, a world-class roller skater and computer engineer in Venice Beach, to talk history, community, social media, and what skating means to this new generation of roller skaters.
One of the main things that we used to say to people just when we met them was, oh, you can come skate with us. Like, everyone's welcome. We don't even care if you have inlines on or, you know, quads, or if you're on a skateboard, or if you're on, you know, a free skate. You can come skate with us, and this is the cruise that we're on, so you can join us. We have music. And so that gave us a lot of freedom to prevent any, like, preemptive judgment or expectation of other people. Because all you need to do is have something on wheels and then you can come. So it's really, it's nice to see such an eclectic, unique space that's been created.
So skating has definitely like gained popularity. I'm not gonna use the term that it like died, because it's definitely like been around, but as far as like a means of like the boon that it has obviously taken this year, like there's no denying that it's blown up. I think comes back to that like sense of community. It's like I said, like that's why I clinged onto it. In the beginning it was because the gyms are closed and I like needed something to do, but I stayed because of the people. Like I have this huge family now. There's like 100 people here. It's wild.
But roller skating wasn't always so inclusive. Here's a brief history of roller skating roots in America. In 1760, the first semblance of roller skates were invented by Joseph Merlin in London, England. Merlin infamously made a grand entrance wearing them into a masquerade while simultaneously playing the violin, only to come crashing into a full-length mirror. 1863, American James Plimpton redesigned the roller skate. This is known to be the birth of the quad skates that we see today. His invention introduced the ability to skate curves and backwards. The 1940s through 1968, the Civil Rights era and segregation. At this time, there was a deep segregation embedded into American society. During the 1940s and 50s, some of the first sit-ins were actually skate-ins, as African Americans protested the right to skate in roller rinks and for basic rights in society. African Americans were denied entry into rinks. Some rinks did allow one night per week for them to skate, often calling them soul nights or Martin Luther King nights. On August 27, 1963, a man by the name of Ledger Smith skated 685 miles in 10 days from Chicago to Washington, D.C. to attend Martin Luther King's I Have a Dream speech at the Lincoln Memorial. This act showed the resilience of the Black community. The 1970s, the roller disco era. Flashing lights, disco balls, flare pants, and funk music took over this decade. However, segregation continued. This in turn led African Americans to start developing their own skate style in movements and music. This is largely the dance skate style that we see prevalent on social media today, and this time period is noted significantly for cultivating it. During this time, Black skaters also began to take to the streets of Central Park, New York, and Los Angeles as sanctuaries to skate, but not without opposition, as police attempted to implement laws that would restrict loud music to deter people from gathering. 1980s, the mass decline. By the early 1980s, the popularity in roller skating had begun to fizzle out, with roller rinks closing across the country.
The park will survive with or without the skaters, but the nearby skate rental agencies won't. Business is not good.
Our business has significantly dropped off. We still have a steady flow of people, but before there'd be lines out the doors and things like that, just a flood of people, and there isn't that way anymore.
2020 to present, the roller skate resurgence and social media. The fast demand for roller skates over the pandemic led to the pop-up of new brands looking to capitalize off of the increase in new skaters, with sites selling out across the country. And in turn, new social media influencers looking to partner with brands and make a name for themselves in the space, sharing quick videos through TikTok and Instagram that could reach audiences across the globe. This in turn was met with controversy from established skaters over the quality of skates being sold, and brought about the question if African American roller skaters were now facing cultural appropriation for the dance style that they had cultivated and being overlooked in the midst of the flashy and fast-paced environment of novelty and social media trends. Scrolling on Instagram one day, I found Dee Upshaw, a professional and world travel roller skater heavily involved in the skate scene in Venice Beach, and wanted to reach out to hear the thoughts of someone who's seen skating transform throughout the decades and holds insight into African American culture.
My name is Dee Upshaw. I am a roller skater and also a computer scientist, skated in 49 countries and counting.
So where did it all start, and how have you seen roller skating change throughout the decades?
I started in Atlanta, so I'm originally from Atlanta, Georgia. And I started when I was 4 years old in the neighborhood. That was something that the kids in the neighborhood would do around Christmas time. People would get skates and put on skates. And the place that we lived, it had a big, big, big parking lot. And it was almost like an oval. So it almost mimicked a skating rink. So we would skate around the parking lot. And that's what we would do. Now, at 4 years old, I wasn't very good at all. I failed all the time. You know, I could barely stand up, but that's when I started. Hey, you got to start somewhere, right? So 11 or 12, I forget exactly when, about 11 or 12 years old, that's when I started to skate every single day. I used to practice every day. I did it for the love of it. I still do it for the love of it. But at some point in time, someone saw me actually skating, and they were like, you're pretty good. You mind if I take a video of you skating? I'm like, found me. It was about to be this director, and he was casting for a national TV commercial. And, you know, his team contacted me, and I went in, and I ended up doing a national TV commercial. And that's how I got started professionally. So I've seen a lot of the different styles, and, you know, whether it be in Germany, or whether it be here, or whether it be in Japan, or whether it be in Texas, New York, LA. So where I'm going with this is that with regards to the different types of music and the different things that people are doing, honestly, it's always been that way. People just didn't see it. And the reason they didn't see it is because they didn't have this thing called social media where you could just press a button and literally you're showing things to everybody all over the world. So the exposure is what has changed now.
So how have you used social media to teach about your passion about roller skating?
I have a social media account, but I must say that I was very hesitant for a long, long time. But then someone, you know, actually quite a few people, actually a lot of people, they came to me, they say, look, Dee, you have so much information and knowledge and experience, and it would be a crying shame if you didn't share it with people. And I said, no, you got a point. Okay, I'll do it.
Do you think there's any obligation for people to know or learn about that history before they start skating? How do you feel about that?
I think it's extremely important for people to know where skating came from and also the grassroots of what the popularity of skating is. That a lot of the skating, especially the skating that you're seeing these days on, you know, TikTok and Instagram and things of that nature, most of that came from the urban communities. You know, where I'm from in Atlanta, you know, when I was growing up, there was like, you know, 4, 5, 6 skating rinks that you could go to. Okay. Now, if you're from in the middle of, you know, Sunglass, Nebraska, you might have had 0. And so you may have known nothing about it, because sometimes when you hear people in the skating community get up in arms and upset, it's usually because someone doesn't recognize that, hey, you know, you just had a wonderful opportunity to present itself. But if it wasn't for the people that paved the road before you, those opportunities probably would not be there. I mean, I'll give you an analogy just real quick. You know, LeBron James can make, you know, $40 million in 1 year. But guess what? He wouldn't have made that if someone else, like, you know, Magic or somebody else, you know, Bird or, you know, Will Chamberlain, didn't pave those roads before.
So you think that patience, inclusion, and education is the way forward for this new generation of roller skaters and social media?
Absolutely. So I'm all about inclusivity, okay? So I'm about being communal, welcoming people, having them come in, teaching people, training people, giving them information. But it's also extremely important that people receive the proper information and education with regards to how these things came to be. And that does not take away at all from the fun experience of being able to do it and to enjoy it and to share it.
Getting a chance to have a conversation with someone like Dee was truly insightful. One of the most interesting things that he noted was how in his decades traveling across the world, he had seen that various dance gate styles were always being developed in other countries, and not only in the US, as I had previously thought. I wanted to see what a perspective on roller skating and its history would be like from those who maybe haven't experienced living through as much of its history. So I headed over to meet with Sunset Roller Club, an inclusive skate group in San Diego formed on social media in 2020, to talk with Tuesday, one of its founding members, at their roller disco event, and to discover what roller skating means to them and their community.
I thought that our following would be kind of small and we would just, you know, like maybe have like some cruises here and there, but it felt like everyone kind of picked up on how cool roller skating was around the same time. And so then we started meeting more and more people, and then it took me a while to figure out like what the reason of it was for. I was like, why do we have this platform? This is so weird. And then we did our first donation drive and we raised a lot of money. We're actually doing one this Sunday, and it's Dia de Nino. I said that wrong, but it's the Day of the Kids. So a lot of the art programs got cut completely with COVID. So this donation center outreach, they help make little art packs for like teenagers, which who's giving anything to teenagers, especially like art packs. So it's like a really nice, it's a really nice, cool thing that's going directly to the kids. And everyone's very excited about it. We've already raised quite a bit of money.
What do you think the obligation is for people to know about the historical roots and origins of roller skating?
There's been a lot of really terrible segregation and like racism in the past when it comes to roller skating, and it's been a form of oppression for a lot of people. I think that you have to know the history of it and start reading about, you know, the pioneers of roller skating in America to kind of comprehend like certain elements of it. And then even with roller derby and like the feminist movement, like it's important to know. I think that history in general, especially what's been going on the past year with the whole country and the pandemic and Black Lives Matter and like the big movements that have been happening, and like this, I don't know what to call it, like civil movement that we've been involved in. If you don't acknowledge that and you don't read about your history, you're missing out on a huge chunk of what roller skating is.
I don't know, this sounds like a bold statement, but I don't think there's been anything really like my club. Like, we're like super queer friendly. Anyone can skate with us. And like, we appreciate the history, but we're kind of trying to like make our own history, if that makes sense.
After talking with Dee, Tuesday, and the Hawaiian Werewolf, it's become apparent to me that roller skating has given them a passionate form of self-expression and a bridge between them and their communities. They seem to share in the sentiment that bringing more people to share in their love for roller skating is the movement forward, and one that's making a collective wave in the diverse dance skating community today. A sentiment that does not exclude the importance of understanding its deep origins, so that others might approach the new opportunities and exposure brought about from social media with respect and acknowledgement for the path paved for them long ago. Okay, sounds
and
good.
Last thing.
Yes.
And last thing, at some point in time, I'm gonna need to see you on skates.
I remember watching the movie Roll Bounce as a kid and being transfixed by the sense of flow, soul, and groove radiating from the actors and stunt doubles' feet as they glided across the floor. It's been probably 18 years since I've put on a pair of roller skates, but I'm happy to be doing it now with a community that promotes inclusion, acknowledges history, and is using skating to build communities and move this world forward constructively and together.